All of you are welcome to the MOOC program of AKTU, and today my topic is randomized algorithm NP completeness and approximation algorithm of design and analysis of algorithm. Actually, this is the topic where student do not get too much interest. This is the topic of the last unit of the design analysis of algorithm. So, I will try to make it more interesting. I will try to explain in more interesting way, so this can be understood by everybody. As whenever we listen about NP completeness, randomized algorithm and approximation algorithm, before that you people have studied about all things regarding algorithm analysis, sorting algorithm, graph algorithm. In all kind of the algorithm, we have found the space and time complexity is order of n p power k. N p power k, where n is the input size. So, we generally started to believe ki all of the computation techniques will have such kind of the complexity order of n p power k, but there are number of problems, those are not solvable by n p power k, these are not simply polynomial problem. When we compute the complexity of any algorithm and it comes as a order of n power k, actually it is known as the polynomial type of complexity. So, here in this chapter we are having three topics, one on the randomized algorithm, one other NP complete algorithm and approximation algorithm. Now, the word come as the randomized algorithm. So, what is meant by the randomized algorithm? We have studied the different type of algorithm, but when it comes about the randomized algorithm, it gives the sense that there is some characteristic of randomness, there is some role of the randomness with the algorithm. For example, any randomized algorithm is depend on some random sequence of the number, some random event of a particular activity, and the logic of algorithm is controlled by the that random output. For example, if we want to make a game of playing card, and those are output of those playing card will be random in spite of the input given any kind of that. So, there are two definitions of randomized algorithm, one is through the Wikipedia and another is through the another is from the Geek for Geek. An algorithm that uses random numbers to decide what to do next anywhere is in logic is called randomized algorithm. This is important to understand. Any algorithm where the logic is decided based on the random number, that is called the randomized algorithm. We should not confuse with the one point, probabilistic analysis of algorithm and randomized algorithm. In probabilistic analysis of algorithm, actually we give the different sequence of the input based on the probabilistic probability distribution, and based on those sequence of the input we analyze the performance of algorithm. But here in randomized algorithm, what we are doing ki logic of the algorithm, say algorithm is the set of the instructions, the sequence or execution logic of the algorithm is depend on some random number, some random sequence some random event, random output of the event. So, these are called the randomized algorithm. We can see this is what is the one example of deterministic algorithm, where there is an input and output. The algorithm is working here. The output as well as running time are the function of only input. This algorithm is implied on the input and the output is coming. So, there is no role of any external entity. This input is solely responsible for a particular output. But when we talk about the randomized algorithm, the same algorithm, the algorithm where input is different, but we are supplying some random information or random data, and this output is depend on output or the running times are the function of the input and random bits only. So, this role of this random bits makes any algorithm as a randomized algorithm. So, again I want to repeat it, any algorithm where its running time and its output is depending on input as well as the some random information, some random bits, some output of random events, then this called a randomized algorithm. If we go for the randomized algorithm, it is that depend on the random number of its operation. These randomized algorithm using random numbers to help find a solution to a problem. Sometimes these random numbers are so important, those helps to find out the solution of the problem. For example, if we talk, we have the very good example since our class 12 mathematics, where we had talked, where we have studied about the playing cards. If we want to know the what possible outputs will be there with when using those play card, and actually it is happening randomly. So, we need to generate some random number to simulate this random event. So, this helps in to solve the problem where the random numbers are important. Using random numbers to improve the solution to a problem, sometimes we need to use these random numbers to improve the solution of a problem. There are the topics which are related are getting or generating a random number, generating a random number data for testing purpose. But now it comes how to get these random number. Once it is very clear ki this randomized algorithm it actually depend on the some random numbers, random informations. So, now the question comes how to generate those random numbers. Generally computer computer does not produce pure random number. Actually they generate the pseudo random number, and these pseudo number random number are generated by different algorithm. Pseudo numbers looks random, but are perfectly predictable if we know the formula, and then we can predict the sequence of repetition of those number. There always exists a particular cycle that that is equivalent to the previous random number generated random number. Now, device for generating random truly random number do exist, but they are based on radioactive decay or some system clocks. Based on using those radioactive decay or some natural events, using some information from there, we can generate random numbers. Now, one very popular algorithm to generate the random number is linear congruential method. That is here R is equal to A into B, A into R plus B, remainder of M, where A and B are large prime numbers, and say M may be from 2 power 16 to 2 power 32 and 2 power 64. The initial value of R is called the seed. If we start over the same seed, we get the same sequence of random number after a particular cycle. One advantage of linear congruential method is that it will cycle through all possible numbers. There are complex mathematical tests for randomness, which we should know if we want to roll our own. There are statistical tests, statistical mechanism to test the randomness of the any sequence. So, we can go through that one, but our objective is not here to going through with the statistical study. Our objective is to understand the randomized algorithm. So, if we there are one very popular random sequence is that called the Gaussian distribution. This Gaussian distribution is a collection of those random variables which captures the most of the practical phenomena, natural phenomena. Like this is a normal curve with mean 0 and standard deviation of 1, and most real natural data like shoe size, quiz score, amount of the rainfall, length of the life, etcetera, fit a normal curve. But some to generate the realistic data with Gaussian distribution, we can use this formula. But some unnatural data like say every human is having maximum height, say we took the sample of the maximum height, say 6.5 feet. If so, whenever we draw the normal curve, so we will see the probability of the having the 6.5 feet is some certain probability. But when we talk about the a person is having the height as the 8 feet, it is not a natural phenomena, it is an unnatural phenomena. So, in that case normal curve does not fit, therefore, the heavy tailed distribution, heavy tailed curves are getting fitted over there to generate the those random number sequences. For example, if we want to know the probability of those persons who are having the billion and trillion of the wealth, this is not the natural phenomena, but there is this small probability to having those persons which are having such enormous income. So, for those type of phenomena, this Gaussian distribution does not work. What was the intention to discuss these two mechanism to generate the random sequence? Because as per our previous discussion, we came to know that for randomized algorithm, we need some random sequence of the number. Now, say if we know ki in some algorithm, we want to put the waiting time of a one customer at any place, and that is the random number. Using that waiting time, we are going to solve some problem. So, if we want to solve the problem, so we need to generate the random number. So, we have discussed here there are two mechanisms, one is linear congruential method, another is Gaussian distribution method. There are many more probability distributions are available in our mathematical sciences. Those depict the different kind of random activity, and output of those random activities are modeled by the different distributions. But here now the basic question may arise, how to check the randomness. Here there are As I have discussed earlier, I have told earlier, there are number of statistical tests, those are used to check the randomness, but here if we talk about the very simplest method, those can be understood by very easily. Say declare an array count of 20 locations. If we declare an array count of the 20 locations and do the following 1000 time, fill an array of size 20 with number 1, 2, 3 to 20, shuffle the array, array has been shuffled, find the location lock at which the 5 number is present. For example, initially say there is an array of 20 size and 1 to 20 numbers are stored on the respective locations, 1 is the first location, 2 is the second location, 3 is the third location, 4 is the fourth locations. Now, what we do? We shuffle this array. When we shuffle this array by any mechanism of randomization, so now we check what is the position of 5. The next time I got some different position, for again we shuffle the array, next time say we got the different position of the 5, for next time we shuffle the array. So, if we do the 10,000 times this array, then we can see the position of the 5 is actually purely random or pseudo random. Purely random means the position of the 5 as changing from 1 to 20, the sequence which we are getting is not going to repeat at all throughout any number of experiment, but unfortunately, as we have said earlier, we have discussed earlier, ki pseudo random number are not actually pure random numbers. There is no device exists by which we can generate the pure random numbers. So, there are different mechanisms by which we generate the random numbers and we test for the randomness, how, what is the degree of randomness, and we use those for in different type of algorithm. So, point now, this is clear by the let us see, this is very popular problem, 01 knapsack problem. As we know, this is the problem the student studies in the part in the dynamic programming and greedy algorithm at the both places, you study the 01 knapsack problem. It is the problem where one thief is gone inside of some house and he is trying to fill his bag with precious item and he is trying to put more and more item, so its cost should be the high. So, we have seen with the greedy approach, we do not find the exact optimal solution for this 01 knapsack problem, but when we apply this 01 knapsack problem with some random information. For example, if thief has put some item in the bag, now we are choosing what next item should be taken, so profit can be maximization. So, we generate the random number, we have assigned a number to every item and we generate the randomly those numbers and we put those numbers, we try to put those number in the bags and we see the how this cost is maximized. So, we have seen in the greedy algorithm of 01 knapsack, and we have seen we do not get the optimal solution or best solution, but with the help of this randomized algorithm of 01 knapsack, we can get the more good solution. Like, you probably won't get an optimal solution this way, but you might get a better one that you started with. Remove a randomly chosen item from the knapsack, replace it with the other items. If the result is a better solution, keep it, else go back to the previous solution. Repeat this procedure as many times as desired. So, now question arises, for how many times we should keep on do this procedure? For example, we cannot go for infinite time. So, we started to observe, say this is the maximum after say 10,000 tile, we observe this is the maximum profitable sequence, maximum profitable sequence of the items which is coming from since last 10,000 iterations. So, we can stop there, and with the hope of that, that we got the best solution. Now we can summarize randomized algorithm is this: sometimes we want to random number for their own sake. For example, we want to shuffle a virtual deck of cards to play a card game, like many of the peoples have played the play card game on the computer, and every time whenever they click, they got the different sequence of the playing card. So, how to get the those different every time new sequence of the play card? This can be only find with the help of the random numbers equation. Say if we want to make the 4 piles of the play card, and these are each pile is having the 13 cards. So, from 1 to 52, we need to generate random 13 set of the random 13 numbers. Those will represent a particular card, and that will help to get a virtual deck of cards. Sometimes we can use random numbers in a simulation, such as the Q example, to avoid difficult mathematical problem or when there is non feasible algorithm. For example, as we have discussed about the 0-1 knapsack, we do not have any feasible solution for this 0-1 knapsack, and we cannot compute for a long time. So, these random numbers, random sequences help us, and randomized algorithms are basically experimental. Almost certainty won't get perfect or optimal result, but we can get pretty good results. Typically, the longer we allow a randomized algorithm to run, the better is the result. A randomized algorithm is what we do when we don't know what to do. So, randomized algorithm help us to solve any problem, and where we do not know what to do. Say, for example, if we have talked about the playing card game, we don't know in what sequence actually playing cards will come. If we are talking about some motion of the some movement of any particle, and that particle is moving randomly. Now, how to solve it, how to model this problem? So, these random number help us to simulate this one. For example, we do not know ki what will be the sequence of the customer to come at any serving station. We do not know what will be the sequence of the traffic in a particular area. And now, we want to model, we want to know about the traffic density and other parameter, we want to study that one. So, at those places, these random numbers and randomized algorithm works well. So, again I want to make it very difference very clear. In randomized algorithm, as we have seen, apart from input and output, there is role of some random information, some random weights, some random number, some random outcome. But when we talk about the probabilistic analysis of algorithm, it means knowingly we are giving a random input to the algorithm, and we are trying to find out the performance of that algorithm and corresponding output. So, these are the two things, and when this is a very popular example, you must have studied in your unit 2 or 3, when we talk about the different sorting algorithm. So, quick sort algorithm is very well known to computer science graduate students. Those have studied in like in second year, as well as they are studying in third year. So, as per the quick shot algorithm of quick shot, I want to summarize that this whole mechanism of quick shot is depend on the selection of pivot. Pivot is the point where the array is divided, and based on that pivot, the greater numbers are separated on one side, a lesser number than pivot is separated on one side. So, the selection of the pivot is very crucial, very important. For example, luckily, if we got a pivot exactly like median or mean value of those numbers. So, every time whenever it comes to select the pivot, we are getting the actual median or mean number. At that time, what we will find, every time my problem is dividing in equal two parts, and with the help of recursion we can solve as a best case, but it does not happen in practically. Practically what happens? Practically happens ki any number can be selected as a pivot by as per the algorithm. If algorithm is working on the philosophy ki we will select every time the middle number as a pivot, based on that middle number we will make the separation of the number less than on the one side and greater than other side. As far we have also seen the worst case of algorithm, when it comes ki all numbers are equal or all numbers are sorted. So, we found ki this pivot does not work as well. So, to overcome with this one, to improve the performance of quick shot, to make ensure of improving the performance of the quick shot, we use random selection of pivot, not by any rule. By a rule, what we do? We always find out the middle number, but in randomized algorithm, actually based on that random number generated, random number means there is an array length of the 10. So, any number between 1 to 10 is generated. So, that number works as the pivot, and based on that pivot, quick shot algorithm started to work. So, it has been observed, no input can elicit worst case behavior. Worst case occurs only if we get unlucky number from the random number generator. What is that unlucky? Say worst case is every time occurring in such way ki my q is divided into n minus 1 and 1. So, every time I have to go through with these n minus 1 and 1 item. So, it is not going to every time. Worst case becomes less likely. Randomization cannot eliminate the worst case, but it makes less likely. With the help of randomization, it has been observed ki worst case cannot be eliminated at all, but it can make it less likely. It means we cannot say ki using randomized phenomena for algorithm we can ensure ki that there will not be any worst case, means there will be zero probability of the worst case, but we can say there will be very small probability of the worst case. It is less likely. So, this is one good example of randomized algorithm which we have studied in sorting portion of the course curriculum. And this is what the algorithm, let us see. First part of a quick sort algorithm works with the randomized partition. So, here this random function is giving one index I that is going to behave like pivot, and this index is placed into the AP. So, pivot is now as per the random number generator, the sequence generated for this pivot, and again we call it partition APR, and after that this randomized quickshot works. It is well understood by already you. This is basically a recurrence based algorithm, recursive algorithm. So, randomized quickshot APR, if p is less than r then q, randomized partition APR again called, otherwise randomized quickshot from APQ and from AQ plus 1 to r. So, what happens here? Ki b fix the value of I that was the randomly generated in previous part, the randomly generated this I that is made as a pivot. So, around this pivot the array is divided, and around this pivot array is divided and call the function of the quickshot again. So, when we talk about the formal worst case analysis of quickshot. So, in worst case as we have said ki this partition T n is the runtime T n is the max of the T q plus T n minus q. If one side the array size is the q, other side is n minus q with constant time theta n. So, using substitution method we have already seen this one, guess T n is equal to order of n square, and the induction goal T n should be the less than C n square. Induction hypothesis is this T k for any k which is less than n, is less than number of element, that should be also be less than C k square. This is the method of the induction to proving any algorithm. So, worst case analysis of quickshot, in worst case analysis of quickshot by proof by induction we get this mathematics here, max C q square C n minus q square. Finally, if q is from 1 to n minus 1, q is over the expression q square plus n minus q square achieves a maximum over the range and one of the endpoints. Finally, doing this mathematics we come to the C n square. So, this is a little exercise of the mathematics solving by induction method. So, this gives the solution of C n square. So, order of n square.